Okay, folks, welcome back to this edition of Epic Fails and the potential demise of the turtle drum. So, I had the turtle drum in the front seat of the truck because I wanted to show Doobie. And I went, get off me. I went and got it out this morning. And on the way back to the shop, I was beating on it. And I said, that doesn't sound like it did the day before. So I got it in here. Flipped it over. And right there, you can see that cracked, and that slid up. So, I think one of the videos, or probably several times, you probably remember me saying this thing's going to be under compression and the whole thing's going to blow up. It looks like it happened. But it could also be because I was a bigger dumbass than I thought. And I was lazy because I had this thing in the front seat. I'm sure I had the heater on. And because instead of using some sort of real joinery, I thought I would be a genius and use hot melt. And I bet hot melt glue and car heaters don't go too well together. So whether it was the hot melt glue or the compression of the rawhide, either way, I got a problem. And you can even see now that I look at it, you can see that crease where the rib was. So it's also slid this out. Oh, geez Louise. Hot melt. What a moron. But it is a testament to rawhide too. That's why the Native Americans would often use rawhide on the backs of their bows instead of sinew. Because sinew shrinks in one direction only, where rawhide shrinks in all directions, 360 degrees. You can take a crummy piece of wood and rawhide back it, and it'll draw the cracks out of it, draw the fibers together. But now this rawhide has drawn my turtle into a half-ass sculpture and not a drum anymore. But what I'm going to try and do is use some spring sticks, put the tops up there against the plywood. I've cut them long, weave them into the onto the rib and systematically bend them to put pressure and see if I can knock all this crap back where it needs to go. And then figure out how to keep it there. Like maybe use some real wood glue in a block. All right, let me. Probably just cut the video off. Thank you. Now the danger to this is, how am I gonna do this? If these spring poles spring out, they're probably gonna punch a hole right through my shell. Now I see another problem. This is making me nervous just trying this. Clovis, no, I'm not in the mood right now, really, buddy. I don't want that to spring out and punch a hole in my... Gosh, bless you. Come here, Wood. Come here, Clovis. Go over there and lay down. You stop being such a bitch. I don't understand. What was that noise? I don't know if y'all can hear it, but it's all this little tiny cracking. I gotta figure out a better way to blocking it. I can't see if it's down or not. Okay, genius, now you got it there. What are you gonna do? Your damn spring poles are in the way. To do. Let me see if maybe if I take it out, maybe it'll stay there. I don't know. trying to get the measurement between that rail and this rail so I can make a spring bolt to push this that way. God damn it. That's the length I need. Eight and a quarter will make it eight and a half. We'll try. And glue this block on top of that busted up. Ah, damn it. That could have been bad. How am I going to do this? Let's see. go. Y'all gotta go. Get going now. Oh, I think my drum is becoming a sculpture. God bless it. I'm going to try this a different way. If it was going to blow up, I wish it blew up in the beginning. Not after I got 100 hours in the damn thing. Thank you. All right, I gotta take a break and think about this. I'm getting irritated. I'm gonna do something stupid. Let me just sit back and think a moment.